Alright guys, today we're going to do a little recap video on how I caught my fish on the second stop of the Bassmaster series on the Tennessee River out of Knoxville, Tennessee. And after this, I'm going to go race that RC boat behind me because that sucker's going about 65 miles an hour.
Why did it start with?
And I think I can crush that thing. He's definitely going to get me out the hole, but I think I can catch up to him in the long run. So going after we get done with this recap, I'm going to race that sucker.
This is Ace.
Oop, dripped it on me. Dadgummit. If you want to get you some coffee to drip on you whenever you can, Welcher 15 will get you 15% off Black Rifle Coffee right now. I've had that code for a couple of videos now, haven't told y'all that. If you want to make an order, your first order only, Welcher 15, 15% off. And you can drip it on your nice Striker active pants also. So let me dig out my rods I used.
And it might even drip onto your Ranger suit.
Yeah, you never know. You just never know. You might could drip it anywhere you want it. So, gotta dig the rods out and give you a little review of how I caught them. So, let's go. All right, guys. So, I'm gonna start with the least amount of fish caught on a bait and go towards the most amount of fish caught on a bait. I only caught fish on three different baits. One bait was the one that I threw the most, being a flat side crankbait. We'll get to that at the very end. I'll show y'all the exact setup that I used for everything that I was fishing in that exact tournament. So, tournament's been over and I've been fishing a couple of times since then, so I have changed out the exact baits on these rods to some different colors, some different weights and stuff like that, just for the conditions I've had home in Alabama. But these are the exact setups that I was using up there, just a little bit different baits on there. So number one, I was actually using a 3/8 ounce finesse jig. Like, I cut the skirt down very small. I was throwing a little chunk style trailer on the back and I was throwing a 3/8 ounce up around some of these docks whenever it was super sunny on day one. That's one of the things I did, and I caught a few fish on that. Only one keeper though on a little 3/8 ounce jig, and I was actually throwing that on 18 pound shooter because I was downsized the jig big time. So I went to a thinner line that'll give me a little bit more of a natural fall rate, and I was only fishing, you know, 2.5 to 4 feet deep under most of these docks. So I went ahead and went to a 3/8 ounce jig, give me a little slower fall, make me go a little bit slower, and I'd work that bait extremely slow trying to catch those fish because the water temp was only 45 degrees. So 7'3" heavy point blank rod that I built myself. This one has all titanium guides, an 8-to-1 Shimano reel. This is actually the Metanium I was using to skip one of those docks. And like I said, 18 pound shooter around the docks. And that was my number one setup that I only caught one keeper on. I only caught one keeper on it on day one. On the rest of the days, I pretty much caught them on these other two baits. So I really tried a lot to fish a ton of docks in this tournament because there was some really good bites to be had around docks. And the number one bait that I was using, because we had a lot of wind, a lot of rain, and a lot of overcast conditions, I was able to skip just a vibrating jig underneath the docks. This one in particular is actually a 1/2 ounce jackhammer Z-Man Chatterbait. I can say the brand because I'm not sponsored by any company that makes these, but it's basically just a standard jackhammer. And what I was able to do under these docks, first off, I'm gonna show you the trailer I was using. I was using a very streamlined trailer that does not catch a lot of water. And the reason for that was it's easier for me to keep that bait down like 4 feet deep whenever I have a bait that's really, you know, doesn't have much water resistance on back. It's just a very streamlined trailer. I can get that bait down a little bit deeper and I can reel it relatively slowly and still keep it down deeper. And the trailer's not gonna add any drag and cause the bait to lift up very much. So that's the bait that I was throwing the most around the docks. And I actually tried a lot in the tournament. I'd fish a stretch of docks I thought was super good. I might catch a fish or two underneath them. I would turn around and go back through flipping a jig or flipping a worm, and I never got a bite fishing behind myself. So it really allowed me to, on the end of days two and three, to really cover a ton of water and go extremely fast with this chatterbait, because I never felt like I was fishing over fish, because whenever I went back and fished slower, I never caught another one. So the setup I was throwing this on is a 7'3" medium heavy point blank rod, a 7-to-1 gear ratio Shimano reel. This is actually a Chronarch. This is 18 pound shooter also, fish around them docks. In that cold water, I wanted to downsize line just a little bit, just to give that vibrating jig a little bit more vibration and help me fish that bait a little bit deeper, because the main depth I wanted to be in was in the 4 to 5 foot depth range. I caught some out of like 2.5 to 3, but mostly it was around that 4 foot range. So this is the bait that I was able to cover a ton of water with, skip it under a lot of docks. I caught a bunch of fish on this bait every single day, but primarily short fish. It was very difficult to catch a 14 incher on that lake. It was, you know, surprisingly difficult actually. So The last rod is the most important one of the week, and I have changed colors during the week. I was actually throwing a more brown and a little bit of red crawfish pattern with a brown body. I mean, with a bright orange belly, but this right here is just a flat-sided crankbait. This one is actually the Spro Little Giant, but that's about what I was throwing in the tournament, was just a flat-sided bait like this. Really important deal. I found one crankbait that I felt like I could get the most bites on this one because it seemed to thump the hardest. So I was actually changing hooks every single day. I was putting a new set of number 5 Gamakatsu treble hooks on the same crankbait every single day. And what I was really doing with this is I was trying to find isolated drops on the flattest banks that I could find. And I was like if I could find a super flat bank that might have had one little place where it dropped off just a little bit deeper, a little bit faster, I would really throw this bait and make multiple casts to the same place. And I would get this bait down in 3, 3.5, 4 feet, and I would reel this bait as slow as I possibly can and just, you know, retain that bottom contact. And I could feel this bait thumping coming back to me, and I was fishing it as slow as I possibly can in these high percentage areas. And the rod I was throwing this on, this is actually a 7-foot cranking blank. Custom built this myself. This is a 7-to-1 Shimano reel and 10-pound Sunline shooter line. That's the exact setup that I was throwing. Like I said, this is not the exact crankbait I was throwing because I have put this one on later to imitate more shad. Whereas up there in the Knoxville area, I was imitating crayfish primarily, so I had on a brown and red one. But still a flat-sided crankbait nonetheless. And then I had, you know, like I said, 10-pound line. So that's the main deals that I was trying to use to cover the water that I was covering. The biggest thing that I found that week fishing on the Tennessee River is there was a major biting window every single day. And on day one, I missed both of the major biting windows. And then on day two, I kind of figured out when the major biting window was, and I caught them all late in the day. And then on day three, I realized that was the major biting window, and then at the end of the day, I went and I tried to implement the same exact patterns that I had put at the correct time of the day, and I just happened to lose a couple fish on the last day, which is fine. You're going to lose a few every once in a while. On days one and two, I never lost a fish that would have helped me. On day three, I definitely did. I lost one pretty dang big largemouth, and then a couple more small ones that would have really helped me a ton. But that's all right. That's going to happen from time to time. Day one, the issue was I missed the major biting windows. But it really didn't seem to matter the baits that I used. And I felt like on day one, I just went a hair too slow. So I only weighed in like 4 pounds on day one. Then we caught two big smallmouth on day two. Both of those were on the flat-sided crankbait. And I think on day two, four or maybe all five of my fish came on the flat-sided crankbait. And then on day three, one came on the flat-sided crankbait and all the other ones came on the chatterbait. So it just kind of changed. You just had to cover as much water as you could. And whenever you got a bite on something, just pray that it was at least 14 inches. So that's what I did on the Tennessee River. Hope y'all enjoyed that. I really do apologize about the camera problems that we had that week. We couldn't get it together. This whole year so far, we have not gotten it together as far as YouTube goes in the tournaments. St. John's, I cracked my lens somehow, got water in the lens, ruined like 2.5 days of footage on Tennessee River, day two. For whatever reason, the camera froze and we missed the last half of the day. Whenever I caught all the fish, somehow we missed it. So we just haven't gotten it together yet, but we're gonna work harder, do better. We'll have at least two or three cameras running all day long, so we'll have some footage no matter what from now on. But we had some camera issues, so didn't have that so far, but we're gonna do better, I promise you. So if you wanna see the videos we do a little bit better on, hit the subscribe button, turn the notification bell on so you don't miss anything, and we will see y'all in the next video. I'm about to go film one right now because I know what's happening. Let's go catch them in Alabama. But we'll see y'all. Pick week is coming up 1 week from now. So check back. You don't want to miss those videos.